Welcome to Dorman Products installation video for our OE Fix VVT cam phaser for vehicles that use Ford's modular 4.6 and 5.4 liter V8 engines. This part features improvements on the failure-prone original equipment design, but installs just like the factory part. We're installing this cam phaser on a Ford F-150. The procedure will be similar but may vary slightly for other vehicles that use this engine. This installation is considered expert and may take 10 to 12 hours or more to perform. Start by removing the air intake assembly, draining the cooling system, and disconnecting the battery. Loosen the cooling fan and fan shroud. Then disconnect the upper radiator hose and remove the fan and shroud from the vehicle. Disconnect the powertrain control module and remove it along with its bracket for additional clearance at the back of the engine bay. Unplug the ignition coils and fuel injectors. And remove the crankcase ventilation tube, being careful not to damage it. Remove the coil packs by taking out the bolt that holds each one in place. Unplug the cam phaser harness and remove the bolts holding the valve cover in place. On this vehicle, it may be easiest to access some of the rearward valve cover bolts by loosening the fender liner and coming in from the side. Pull the valve cover off the engine and set aside. Disconnect the harnesses for the mass airflow sensor and fuel rail pressure sensor. Then remove power steering reservoir and its mounting bracket. Disconnect the coil pack and fuel injector harnesses on the other valve cover and remove the coil packs. Remove the valve cover bolts and then lift the valve cover away from the engine. With the top of the engine dismantled, move to the front side, starting with removing the drive belt. Remove the accessory pulleys, idlers, and belt tensioner from the front of the engine. Remove the power steering pump from its bracket and set it out of the way. Remove the crankshaft bolt and with a crank puller, dismount the crank pulley from the crankshaft. Remove the brackets securing the hard power steering line to the front engine cover. Remove the bolts holding the front engine cover to the engine. With all the front cover bolts removed, pull the engine cover away from the engine. Remove the crank trigger wheel. Refer to an official workshop repair manual to ensure the timing components are properly aligned and locked into position. It is critical that these components are precisely located to ensure proper timing and to avoid engine failure. Remove the timing chain tensioners and loosen the curve guides to remove the timing chains from the cam phasers on both sides. If you are replacing the guides as well, you can remove them at this stage once the timing chains are out of the engine. Before starting reassembly, clean the gasket flanges to remove any old material. Reinstall the timing chain guides, leaving them loose enough to allow the chains to be installed. Remove the old phasers and replace them with the new parts, making sure to position them correctly for left or right position according to the marks on the back of the phasers. Torque the new cam phasers to the camshaft according to factory specification. Reinstall the timing chains starting with the driver's side. Proper installation order is critical here. Reinstall the timing chain tensioners, torquing them to factory specifications. Apply gasket sealer to the gasket flanges on the front of the engine. Install a new rubber gasket on the front engine cover, then reinstall it on the engine. Reassemble the rest of the components in the reverse order of installation and refer to a factory workshop manual for correct torque specs. An oil change is recommended following reassembly. If at any point you have issues, the Dorman Technical Support Team is standing by to help.